Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit and welcome to my YouTube channel where I share videos on engineering mathematics and B.Sc if you are preparing for competitive exams which require higher mathematics, then my channel is very helpful. Here in this iTab you can check out my differential equation videos on my channel. Today I am going to teach that what is exact differential equation. But before understanding this topic, I have already uploaded a video where I explained exact differential equations. Then I explained two rules of reducible exact to you. The video link is in the description. Today I am going to discuss the final concept for exact differential equations. If previous concepts didn't apply, don't worry. This one is simple and works for any problem. The only condition is that the integrating factor should not appear in the power of e. If the integrating factor is expressed in terms of the power of e, then you can't use this method. If the integrating factor appears in the power of x or y, then you can easily use this method in that case. Let's see how. So I'll be showing you two rules for finding integrating factors here. First rule is this, and sometimes this is very helpful in some particular questions. But when the question is not in this specific form, applying this method can take some time. So I will introduce another method for such cases. Both are the same although. If we have any differential equation in this form where it is x power a, y power b and my dx plus nx dy and x power a dash, y power b dash, m dash y dx, n dash x dy equals to 0. If x to the power h and y to the power k is the integrating factor, then to find the values of h and k, we have two equations here. Solve them to determine the values of h and k and you get the value. How? Let's see it now. And as you can see, we have this question here. If I compare this question to the previous one, then observe that how do we write it? It is 2y. Dx plus 3x dy and further in the equation, we have 2 at this point. Now let's multiply this 2 inside. Plus xy, 6y dx plus 8x dy. Now in this equation, the product of the terms ahead will be x to the power a and y to the power b. Notice that the values of a and b are absent, indicating they are 0. We can write it as x power 0. Similarly, we have here y to the power 0. Here as you can observe that we have a dash and b dash and the value of each is equal to 1. The coefficient of y dx in the equation is m. Similarly, at this point, we have 3 here. In the same way, when we discuss this, hence here, this m dash will be 6 and this n dash will be 8. And now students, in this particular case, let integrating factor be x to the power h, y to the power k. So, we have a relationship here. And the relationship is h plus a plus 1 upon. And here in the denominator, we have m, which is equal to k plus b plus 1 upon n. And further in the other equation, on this side, we have h plus a dash plus 1. And in the denominator of this expression, we have m dash, which is equal to k plus b dash plus 1 upon n dash. Now we take this value and put it here. So here we have this h plus a. As we know, a is 0 plus 1 divided by, as the value of m is 2, so put 2 here, is equal to, here the second equation that we get will be k plus 0. Plus, this will be 1 here in the numerator and in the denominator we have 3. When you multiply this, it will become 3h plus 3, which is equal to this expression 2k plus 2. Then we will simplify this to get 3h minus 2k, which is equal to minus 1. So we have one equation here. Now we will take the second one. Looking at this result, we will have h plus a dash and a dash has a value of 1. Thus, this will be the value of a dash. And then we have plus 1 here. And it is equal to k plus 1 plus 1 divided by. It is m and n, so this is 6 and 8 and it is kh plus 2 and k plus 2. And cancel this, so here we have 4, here we have 3. Now multiply this. Here we get 4h and this 2 multiplied by 4 becomes 8. Therefore, here we get 3k plus 6. Let's simplify this. Now, the equation that we will obtain as a result will be 4h minus 3k is equal to minus 2. Now we need to solve these two equations. Therefore, in the next step, we will cancel this k here. So for this, I will take this equation and I will multiply it by 3 and multiply this by 2 so that here it becomes 6k and it gets cancelled. Therefore, let's do it here so that we have space separately. Now I will multiply it by 3. At this point here, it will be 9h minus 6k is equal to minus 3. In the next step, we will multiply it and we will have 8h minus 6k, which is equal to minus 4. In its continuation, these figures will be plus, minus and plus. So these will be cancelled out. Now, the value of h is 1. So we would take this value and put it here. This way, the value of k is 2. Now, in the equation, put these values of h and k here. So our integrating factor will be, that will be x to the power 1. And in this way, y to the power is 2. This way, we get the integrating factors. Now, we multiply this. our equation will be reduced to an exact form. Now I will show how to find integrating factor. After this, you can easily multiply and solve this equation. Now I will explain another method that can also be applied here without any issues. Please take a look. So please pay attention. Let an integrating factor is. And here we get in the equation x to the power h and y to the power k. X to the power h, y to the power k. And this will be y square plus. Further in the equation, we have 2x square y into dx plus 2x cube minus xy into dy equal to 0. And when we multiply this, we will get x to the power h and y to the power k plus 2 plus 2x to the power h plus 2 and y to the power k plus 1. This will be our mdx. And when we multiply this with this, then here we will get x to the power h plus 3, y to the power k minus. And at this point here, we get x to the power h plus 1. And further, while solving it, we get y to the power k plus 1 into dy will be equal to 0. In this case, we have m dash and similarly, we have n dash here. Now, we are going to differentiate m dash with respect to y. As you can observe that, here we have k plus 2, x to the power h and y to the power k plus 1 plus 2 as we have here. And further in this equation, k plus 1, x to the power h plus 2, y to the power k. We will differentiate this with respect to x. Then we will be getting 2 and here we have h plus 3, x to the power h plus 2 and y to the power k. As you can see this expression here, and when we differentiate this with respect to, here we will get h plus 1, x to the power h y to the power k plus 1. You can see that the coefficient of this term is equal to this coefficient and the power is evident here. Both the powers are the same, so the coefficient of this term is equal to this one. Hence, we can equate the coefficients as the coefficient of this term equals with this term. Therefore, in this process, we will get k plus 2 is equal to minus h plus 1. And the second coefficient will be equal to this. Hence, as you can see, we have 2k plus 1 is equal to 2. And here we will get this h plus 3, right? You can observe that this h will move here, resulting in h plus k equals minus 3. Additionally, the 2 from this side will cancel out with the 2 on the other side. Then it will be minus h and plus k, and this 1 went over there. In our case, this will become 2. Now, you can observe that at this point, it will be minus h plus k equal to 2. We will proceed by adding both of these here. 2k is equal to minus 1. Therefore, we can easily determine that the value of k is minus 1 by 2. As mentioned, the value of k is this. We will substitute this value here. Now, minus h minus 1 by 2 is equal to 2. So, minus h is equal to, as this 1 by 2 went on the other side, so it is 5 by 2. So, the value of h will be minus 5 by 2. Hence, the integrating factor for this equation will be x to the power h, y to the power k. And the integrating factor of this will be x to the power minus 5 by 2 and y to the power minus 1 by 2. This will be the integrating factor, and multiplying it by the equation will reduce it in an exact equation. Now, please provide the answer to this in the comments. X power h and y power k. If it has an integrating factor, then what will be the value of h and k? You have four options here. How long did it take you to solve? You can share in the comments. Thank you for watching. I'm uploading valuable videos on my new channel. If you are preparing for the GATE, IIT-JAM or CSIR exams, then my videos will be helpful. You can visit my playlist to see the new videos on differential equations 2.0 here. You can also follow me on Instagram. Thank you for watching. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.